Well, two police officers testified that despite being severely injured, Jaimie Cates was able to provide them with valuable information.
Milford Police Sergeant Kevin Furlong says the call came in as a possible home invasion and robbery at 4 Trowell Road in the town of Mount Vernon. He was the first to arrive on the scene, looked through the window, and saw an injured, bloodied girl inside. He knocked down the door with his shoulder and found 11-year-old Jaimie Cates.
I saw a young girl laying on the floor. I observed that she was completely covered in blood from her head to her toe. I observed that she had major injuries and major trauma, to include lacerations to her face, extremities, as well as I observed that part of her foot was missing.
Sergeant Furlong says Jaimie was trying to scream, but nothing was coming out of her mouth.
I got close to her. I told her that I was a police officer. I was there to help. She then said in a whisper while shaking that she thought her mommy was dead.
Furlong found Kimberly Cates' body in the bedroom. Milford Police Officer Eric Wales arrived soon after and tended to Jaimie Cates outside the house.
I asked her how this happened, and she said that there was a guy in the house. She said that those guys in the house, one of them had a knife and the other one had a bat, and he hit my mom.
Officer Wales testified that Jaimie Cates could only describe one of the people as bald, but did overhear something.
I had asked her why they were there, and she told me that she heard one of them say, "Get the jewelry."
Now, Officer Wales testified that Jaimie Cates was obviously in shock, but still clear-headed enough to say her father was away on business and even provide his cell phone number. Reporting live, I'm Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.